And obviously now, as we're progressing, we will need to be I'm just checking for wall thickness there. But as we progress, we need to check quite regularly now the depth. It's also important that if you are using this,
sorry, I'll speak to Ken next, alright.
Make sure that there's no debris against the headstock when you put this there, because it will affect the register. Yeah. Okay, so make sure it's nice and clean for the headstock. So, still got 10 feet to go. Happy days, as they say. So, getting relatively close. Remember, if you are using carbide, you can have a bit of a bridge over house. And obviously, now that we're getting down, we have to remember that we're going to have to do some finishing cuts. So you wouldn't go down to millimetre gap and then go, flipping neck, I've got to do some finishing cuts and sand it, because then you'll be through it anyway. So you have to just factor that in. But that's what we'll do anyway. I'm just trying to have a feel, really, so we're keeping consistent.
Does that gap compensate for the inset as well?
Yeah. It's never let me down on that. Since I've used that, probably a couple of years I've had that, and not gone through anything. Mm-hmm. But it works really well. Completely relying on it now. Thank you. So, I know you get lots and lots of wood turners that go super, super thin, and that's their style. You know, I generally don't like to go super, super wafer thin, although I can do it. I did it on a video probably about a month ago, and went down to about a millimetre thickness on the whole bowl, so she sure could do it. But that's getting down now to a nice thickness. So I'm going to get some finishing cuts done now. Would be the last one. So, and this is my whole life. It's start, stop, feel, touch. Remembering in the early days, it was tons of counting. It's like my whole life. It's just like, oh. Thank you. Now we're getting to this set. I'm gonna face shields, great, and they do a wonderful job. But that fabric. Cool down a bit now. So now that I won't be eating as many. So we've got to go the final sorting tool here. Some wax on, just again help keep the dust down. Now we're doing some fine cuts and lubricate it.
Chris, can I ask why do the finishing cut chisels work better than your carbide disc?
I have actually got here. This one, it's got a special angled, been designed at an angle, a specific angle for finishing cuts. That way. So, no, the fine finishing tools, it acts like a finishing scraper. I like the way. That because it's a round 3/4 bar, I can roll it over.